Not enough evidence. That's why the Honolulu Police Department has decided not to pursue a criminal case against one of their own, seen in a video hitting a woman. HPD Chief Louis Kealoha gave lawmakers that reason during a public informational briefing today at the state capitol. HPD officials also talked about their domestic violence policies, procedures, and training, and vowed to make improvements. Christine Oweno has been on this story since the beginning and follows up. Chris?
Joe, HPD officials sat in front of two committees for a little more than an hour and a half, answering questions, concerns, and complaints. And the chief repeatedly told lawmakers HPD is one of the best in the nation. It was a packed house at the state capitol as lawmakers addressed domestic violence concerns prompted by this video. It was taken inside a Waipahu restaurant 3 weeks ago. Domestic violence service providers shared victims' stories, but a large portion of the public briefing focused on HPD and the incident caught on tape.
It's correct that no report was generated because what we think happened is that the officers weren't sent to an abuse case at that time.
Senate President Donna Mercado Kim grilled HPD about its report policy. HPD clarified a written report is not required for every incident that involves a police officer, but a supervisor is required to respond to the scene.
I'm not saying we're a perfect organization, but we're one of the best in the nation. And what makes us the best is we're willing to sit down in this forum and listen to your voices, who you represent the public, and we want to make improvements to this policy, to the quality of our officers, and to prevent abuse.
HPD also shared its domestic violence training, which is 3 hours for recruits and 1 hour per year thereafter. Senator Willis Sparrow expressed concern.
To me, that just doesn't sound like that's a lot or enough.
You know, we're going to go back, we're going to look at this.
Senator, what did you learn in there that you found surprising or even disturbing?
Well, there was a lot of information shared. For starters, I thought that the fact that he wasn't sure how much is spent on training, and that's key to all of this. Also, the fact that they had the video.
HPD was planning to show the entire video at the briefing in front of everyone, but some lawmakers didn't like that idea and decided to watch the video at a later time in private. Lawmakers say their involvement is not over, and issues revolving HPD transparency, reporting, and training will likely pop up during the next legislative session. Even though HPD is not pursuing a criminal case against the sergeant in that video, the city prosecutor has yet to decide whether to press charges. The sergeant remains on desk duty, stripped of police powers, but still earning a sergeant's salary. Christina Ueno, KH12 News.